one's doing what the greats have ever has done in boxing. You know, this social media is just killing the sport. You know, there's fights where my son, you know, wants to fight, but then he doesn't want to fight him because, you know, he doesn't want to be involved in that world of social media. You know what I'm saying? We want to fight real fights.
Okay,
we don't
so let's say
the public fighting ridiculous, stupid fights.
Ryan Garcia, Teofimo Lopez. How do you see the fight unfolding?
Well, my son will kill him. He will destroy him. It wouldn't even be a contest.
Why do you say that? Ryan, 21-0, 18 knockouts.
Because I know my son, and I know who we could beat. I know my son like the palm of my hand. There's nobody out there that could beat him right now. Nobody. I mean, and my son, listen, my son hasn't won by split decision. All his four fights that he hasn't knocked out a guy has been by unanimous decision. So as of right now, we're like 100, you know? You got other cats that I want to name, you know, Hall of Famers that they don't have a record like we have right now. I mean, the record that we have right now is never going to be broken, ever. In boxing history, I mean, they had never the lightweight division had never been undisputed, and when we took all the belts, that had never happened. And we did it. My son did it at 23. He could have probably done it at 22 because they stopped the fight on May 30th. We lost $2 million because of the COVID. We lost him being 22 instead of being 23. You know, a lot of things happened. We made this happen during impossible times. You know what I'm saying? And we still made it happen. You know, for something like this to happen again, I don't see it. I don't see it happening.
I agree with you. At 16 fights, at age 23, never. It just can't happen because your son's something special, because most fighters at 21, 20 barely turn pro, number one. Number two, to get a chance to fight for all the belts, you have to fight so many people and no hiccups. It's almost impossible. And if your son moves up to 140 and fights the winner of Jose Ramirez, Josh Taylor, he has opportunity to do something special too.
And that fight's going to happen because the whole world's going to want to see it. And we want it. And they want it too. You know, because my son is a bigger name than those guys. You know, he's way bigger name right now than those guys put together. You know, because we have accomplished things that nobody has ever done in the sport of boxing. So I don't see no reason why Josh Taylor wouldn't want to fight my son. I don't see no reason why Jose Ramirez wouldn't want to fight my son, even though he's saying that he has to move up to 147. So I don't know what's going to happen. You know, I just want to make sure that we undispute the 140 weight division. And that's what I look for. I look for moments like that, you know, and the way that God is putting it to us is like, it's ridiculous. It's crazy. You know, like I said before, the only thing that could stop us right now is health. You know, and my son is in the best health of his life. You know, I'm doing good as well. You know, I feel young. I feel like 20 years old, you know, and it's just amazing to know that we still got big, you know, other challenges that we could, you know, make us even better than what we are already.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.